Scientific data are the result of carefully controlled experiments. They can be presented in a manner of ways, including tables and graphs. While both can display the same information, graphs can sometimes be used to display the information in a way that makes interpretation of the data easier. For example, the data shown in this table describe the prevalence of autism spectrum disorder, or ASD, a neurodevelopmental disorder that can affect social, behavioral, and cognitive development. Notice that the year of surveillance, the birth year of the surveyed individuals, and the prevalence of ASD are reported. Notice also that if you compare birth year with surveillance year, all surveyed children were 8 years of age. Since the children's age doesn't change, this information can be left out of a graph. Only the surveillance year and prevalence should be included. The information in this table would probably be best displayed as a bar graph since it contains categorical information. The next step is to decide which information goes on which axis. Graphs have two axes. The x-axis, or horizontal axis, displays the independent variable, while the y-axis, or the vertical axis, displays the dependent variable. The number of children with ASD is dependent on the year. The year doesn't change to match the number of children with ASD. This means the year is the independent variable and goes on the x-axis, and the number of children with ASD is the dependent variable and goes on the y-axis. Notice that in our table, the prevalence of ASD is reported as a number of occurrences per 1,000 children. This means our y-axis needs to extend up to 15 to cover the ranges reported. Notice also that the units, in this case, the number of cases per 1,000 children, need to be included. Each year has a bar drawn to display the number of children with ASD. For example, in 2002, for every 1,000 children, 6.6 had ASD. Finally, our graph needs a title. Since it's displaying the prevalence of ASD, we could call it the prevalence of autism spectrum disorder in the U.S. from 2000 to 2010. Notice that a simple glance at the graph is enough to notice trends, whereas you would have to study the table for several minutes to draw the same conclusions.